Welcome back, everybody. Sunny Friday morning on Good Day Colorado. Hey, we cooked last night.
Look, it's like a baby onion. They call it a shallot.
Uh-oh.
I think we got enough. This is...
Ceramic.
You didn't get hurt, did you?
Knife. No, I couldn't.
It's a safety knife.
My wife had to take over cutting up the shallot. So
we see why.
Yeah, I struggled a little bit with that. But listen, in the end, my wife and I cooked this. I think it turned out pretty good.
Nice.
This is what my dish looked like.
Here's the
side-by-side of the right is their picture, the left is my picture.
I'm smelling
material. Well, on the right, that was kind of like a photo shoot.
Yeah, but I think mine looks pretty
good. I think yours is really good.
Now, what percentage was you? What percentage of your wife?
Yeah, 90% of my wife.
There you go. Truth be told.
My wife makes me look good every day of the year. That's just how it goes. So we've got Chef Adam Sachs here from Johnson and Wales University to give us a breakdown. But I do want to say, in all, my experience was pretty good. I mean, cooking it was pretty easy. It tasted fantastic, although there were no leftovers because there just wasn't that much food. Enough to fill us, but that's it.
But that's okay.
That's the whole point here, right? And my wife even said, you know, if we made this ourselves, she felt like we would have made more and overate.
Right.
Which is what we all do.
Or throwing something away, right?
Or throwing something away, which is true, too. So you've had a chance to look at kind of the nutritional breakdown. What do you think? Not a lot of calories.
Not a lot of calories, folks. We're talking about, 400 calories.
Okay.
It's meat-centric, meaning that there's a heavy emphasis on the protein.
Too much protein?
No, I'd say about 40 grams.
Okay.
It's for a guy like you, I'd say that's roughly half what your daily needs.
I'm a fatty.
Absolutely. But you look good in a suit, right?
He needs a lot of calories to keep that tank moving.
Absolutely. And that mouth going.
I wondered about the sodium. I dumped the packet of seasoning on the pork chop, and I thought to myself, is there a lot of salt in here? What's going on? I don't know what's in here.
It's roughly around 1,100 milligrams of sodium.
Is that a lot?
Yes. I mean, that, in terms of the total picture,
sure.
I would say, that's more than enough.
Okay.
Hmm. All right? But in terms of flavor, it's going to be needed. The pork chop is somewhat neutral, so you need an elevated sensation. You need that sensory to give you that satisfaction.
Okay.
And, when you think about it, since it has such a larger meat portion, you probably want the salt because I think that will satisfy you even more. So.
Yeah, well, it was delicious. Honestly, like I said to my wife, if I went to a restaurant and got this, I would be happy with it. So the Home Chef, that's the company, the family plan costs $80 a week. That's two meals a week at about $10 per serving.
Did the kids like it?
The kids didn't eat it.
Didn't.
There wasn't enough for the kids. It was just two servings.
We chopped up some hot dogs, and they were good.
They had mac and cheese, no joke. All right, Greg, so which one did you have?
All right, so I had the Blue Apron, which a lot of people have heard about. This is the time lapse of me cooking it every once in a while. I'll bring over the thing. Teamwork makes the dream work. You can see Amber pops in every once in a while there.
Taking over.
She mashed the potatoes and whatnot, mostly because she loves our little potato masher, and she wanted to steal some of my wine. I liked it. I liked it a lot. My overall impression was it did take a little while to cook it. I mean, we're kind of like the half-hour meal type people.
Yeah.
I love prepping stuff. It's what I did when I was in high school as a job, so I like chopping stuff up and everything and plating up meals. Overall, I think it was pretty good.
Well, this is what it's supposed to look like.
Yeah, right.
Mm-hmm.
I was close-ish.
No,
yeah,
that was all right.
I think that I might have
gone. It was all right.
I might have gone a little overboard on the bok choy. I think I added too much water to it. It was a bit soggy.
Okay,
but that's on me.
Dude, that looks good.
Thank you.
Like
it was pretty good. I did overdo the fish a bit, but I honestly did it on purpose because we had it on the set earlier on the day, and we had it on ice the whole time.
To make sure it was cooked.
Yeah, you don't want to, not be here on Friday to review the meal.
Blue Apron
would be like, So what do you think about it, Chef?
I like this plate.
Okay.
This is a winner for me. I mean, as a nutritionist and a chef, I'm looking at this particular plate. I'm going, wow,
really?
Nutritionally.
Yeah.
I mean, loaded with phytochemicals and antioxidants. You got the healthy fats from the fish, and then you got the, I mean, the vitamin C, the vitamin K,
from
all the vegetables, sweet potatoes.
I love those things.
Absolutely. I mean, this is it. This is it for
this
me.
Is it.
This is it for
your
me.
Your omegas then.
Yeah, and I'm glad I didn't burn it to a crisp then and not do it justice, because we really did like it. And my wife isn't even the biggest salmon person, and she liked it
too.
Absolutely. I mean, this is balance to the key.
Awesome. Yeah. And the cost breakdown?
Yeah, it's not bad. It's the least expensive, so that's good. It's about $70 for a week. That's for two meals to feed four people. We did have leftovers. I didn't bring them in because leftover fish, honestly.
Yeah, it's gross.
Who eats leftover fish? Right. You do you really?
For breakfast, bro.
For breakfast, I could see that.
Put it in an omelet.
I hate warming
it up.
Seafood
omelet. If they were his leftovers,
I love those schmears.
Right,
you know, exactly. Across those bagels.
If I cooked them well enough the first time, they probably would be good the second.
All right, so you guys tested two other boxes. We're gonna have those coming up. Raise your hand if you had a glass of wine while you cooked last night.
I had two.
Raise your hand if you had a martini.
All right. Chef's gonna stick around. We'll have the two other boxes coming up. You gotta stick around as well. But first, let's check in with Hank. He's watching your
traffic. You feeling a little left out over there, Hank?